وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. Today inshallah ta'ala I'm going to share with you this few verses from Surah Al-Furqan, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا يَا وَيْلَتَى لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, here he says, وَيَوْمَ the day. وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ, the wow here, it's ma'atuf, it's connected to the ayah that will be mentioned before that, which is وَيَوْمَ تَشَقَّقُ السَّمَاء. And what it means here is, وَذْكُرْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Remember, contemplate and think over يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. What day? يَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. The word al-'adh, it's when the person ashiddu bil asnan min haythu al-asl. That's what it means. Asl is, but here it means when the person bites on their hands or their fingers. And al-zalim here is referring to the mushrik or the kafir or the one who disbelieves in the messengers or the one who is a sinner. It also refers to as the sinner. Ala yadayhi, it means ala asabi'i yadayhi. He's biting on the his fingers, okay, like this. Ta'asufan, and the reason why he's doing it, he's saddened, regret. Tahassuran wa nadaman, regret. And it is what? Wala ta'sa'ata mandam. This is not a time that it's going to benefit him being sad. Won't do anything for him. Yaqulu, he says, Allah says. And he's saying this mutamanniyan. He's not just saying, he's actually saying because he wishes for something. He says, ya laytani. The word laytani is actually, it's just wishful thinking. It's when somebody wishes for something but doesn't put effort and hard work in. As Abu al-Atahiyya mentions, and he says, أَلَا لَيْتَ الشَّبَابِ, I wish being a youth can come back. يَعُودُ يَوْمًا, can come back one day. فَأُخْبِرُهُ بِمَا يَفْعَلُهُ الْمَشِيبُ, so I can tell him what the senior people are doing, the elderly ones. وَلِذَلِكَ, in the Arab parable, the Arabs, the method, the proverb in the Arabic language is رَأْسُ الْمَالِ الْمَفَالِيسِ is التَّمَنِّي. التَّمَنِّي is what? رَأْسُ مَالِ الْمَفَالِيسِ. The bankrupt ones, their business and their trading is wishful thinking. The ya in ya laytani is للتنبيه. That's what it is. Ya laytani اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. Ya laytani اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. It means a laytani, if only ha ja'altu ma'a rasuli, if only I did with the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tariqan ila al-jannati, I just wish I'd use the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as my means to jannah, bil imani bihi, by believing in him, wa tasdiqi wa tiba'ihi, I wish I just followed the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I took him as a role model, I did what he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed me. Then he says ya waylata. يَا وَيْلَتَا is a nida' ala nafsihi bil wayli wal halak. He's wishing for himself destruction. May destruction be for me. May problems be for me. Huh? لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. If only I didn't take. لَمْ أَجْعَلْ فُلَانًا, if I didn't make so-and-so. الَّذِي أَضَلَّهُ is referring to a particular person who misguided him, who took him away from the truth, from the shayateen al-ins or the shayateen al-jinn. And the person will actually name the person. Fulan, and here it's left general. But that person will name him Fulan and Fulan, who did this to me. Ya laytani, ya waylata, laytani lam attakhid fulanan khalilan. I wish I didn't take him as a khalil. Khalil is a sadiq, it's a habib, someone you chose. And you know the friendship is of different levels. Al khalil is the one الذي بلغت محبته غايتها. It reached the highest level. Reached the high level. Okay. Why? لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني. This person who I took as a friend, I became very close to him. لقد أضلني عن الذكر. This individual, he took me away from. هي لقد أضلني عن الذكر. It's تعليل للتمني السابق. The wishful thinking that he was mentioning before that, he's explaining here. Okay. He's trying to say لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني. This person, when he came to me and he came to my life, he diverted me from the straight path. He took me from the good path and he made me an evil person. As Allah mentioned in the ayah, Al-akhillau yawma'idhin ba'aduhum li ba'adhin adu illa al-muttaqeen. They are enemies to one another. The friends who are bad friends, the ones who are friends upon piety and good, they would be together. They would want to meet each other. Lakin al-akhillau yawma'idhin بعضهم لبعض عدو. Every other person is an enemy to one another that day. Except who? إلا المتقين. Except the righteous people whose friendship was based upon iman. It was based upon العمل الصالح, العلم النافع, beneficial knowledge and righteous action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in Surah Al-Ahzab, ويوم تقلب وجوههم في النار. The day when their faces will be tossed and turned in the hellfire. يقولون, they will say, those people are going to say, يا ليتنا أطعنا الله. Only if we obeyed Allah. وأطعنا الرسول. And if we only obeyed our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وقالوا, they say, ربنا, our Lord, إنا أطعنا, we obeyed سادتنا, our seniors, our people we looked up to, our role models, our, you know, singers and rappers and etc. We سادتنا. وَكُبَرَاءَنَا فَأَضَلُّونَ السَّبِيلَ. They misguided us from the straight path. They took us from the road of Allah تبارك وتعالى. رَبَّنَا, our Lord, آتِهِمْ ضِعْفَيْنِ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ. Multiply the punishment for them. وَالْعَنْهُمْ لَعْنًا كَبِيرًا. Oh Allah, distance from them your mercy. Distance it from them. Look how they curse one another. These are the people who are bad friends, who were not together upon righteous deeds. They were not together based on beneficial knowledge. They will become enemies to one another. As Allah mentioned subhanahu wa ta'ala in that verse and in the verse in Surah Zukhruf. Al-akhilla, the friends. Okay? يَوْمَئِذٍ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٍ. They are enemies to one another. إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ. The exception here are the righteous people. The righteous people will be together. ولذلك ابن القيم, he says, فكل من اتخذ غير الرسول, anyone who takes other than the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, يترك لأقواله وآرائه ما جاء به الرسول, he leaves the prophet's statements and everything for this particular person, فإنه قائل هذه المقولة لا محالة. That person will say that statement يوم القيامة, no doubt. He will say the statement, وقالوا ربنا إنا أطعنا سادتنا وكبراءنا فأضلونا السبيلا. ربنا أتيم ضعفين من العذاب ولعنهم لعنا كبيرا. He will say that. فهذا حال الخليلين المتخاليين على خلاف طاعة الله. They became friends on other than that which Allah تبارك وتعالى was pleased with. Then Allah تبارك وتعالى says, وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا. شيطان, brothers and sisters, he deceives you from the truth. ويعني يصرفه عن الحق. He will divert you from the truth. Ha. And he would what? وَيُزَيِّنُ لَهُ الْبَاطِلِ. And he will beautify the falsehood for you. He will call you to the falsehood. That's what shaytan does. وَلِذَلِكَ Allah تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى mentions in Surah Al-Fatir, Surah Al-Fatir, فَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا إِنَّمَا يَدْعُو حِزْبَهُ لِيَكُونُوا مِنْ أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. Allah also says, وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ إن الله وعدكم وعد الحق ووعدتكم فأخلفتكم وما كان لي عليكم من سلطان إلا أن دعوتكم فاستجبتم لي فلا تلوموني ولوموا أنفسكم ما أنا بمصرخكم وما أنتم بمصرخي إني كفرت بما أشركتموني من قبل إن الظالمين لهم عذاب أليم. شيطان is the one that's going to divert you from the truth, brothers and sisters. He's going to push you towards falsehood. وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا. Shaytan is a deceptive one. Shaytan will plot and plan against you. He will try to throw you into hawiya. That's what he will do. My brothers and sisters, the only way we can overcome all of that is by what? Is by making sure we look at the people who we are around, the people we take as friends. This ayah, it was said that it came down on, as Abdullah ibn Abbas mentioned, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari mentions in his tafsir, he said, Kana Ubay ibn Khalaf, he used to yahdhuru an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and participate with the Prophet. فَزَجَرَهُ عُقْبَةَ مِنْ أَبِي مُعَيْطٍ عُقْبَةَ مِنْ أَبِي مُعَيْطٍ was his friend, stopped him. Why are you doing this? Why are you going to Muhammad? Don't go to Muhammad. Stop going to him. He told him off. And then this ayah came down. وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ It came down. The الظَّالِم here is عُقْبَةَ مِنْ إِبْنِ أَبِي مُعَيْطٍ and فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا is Ubay ibn Khalaf. Okay? Ponder here, brothers and sisters. How many of us have those type of friends who whenever we want to do good, always stand in front of us and stop us from it? Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he said, وَسَوَاءٌ كَانَ السَّبَبُ نُزُولُ هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ It doesn't matter what this verse came down on. Whether it came down on عُقْبَةَ ibn أَبِي مُعَيْط and Ubay ibn Khalaf or not, Ibn Kathir, he said, فَإِنَّهَا عَامَّةٌ It's general, لكن فِي كُلِّ ظَالِمٍ It's talking about every oppressor. Or who does what? Who calls the people away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who calls them to destruction, who calls them to problems, who diverts them from the truth. The zalim was Uqbah ibn Abi Mu'ayt, right? And the one that was being diverted from the truth was Ubay ibn Khalaf. So brothers and sisters, be careful. Don't listen to these evil friends that are around you. Stay away from them. Run away from them. Be a person who surrounds himself with righteous people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us for our shortcomings and our mistakes. Anything which I have said that was wrong, incorrect, is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like, and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.